Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to the Riverside Theatre and to today's show of Jack and the Beanstalk. Please turn off all mobile phones and no flash photography or video recording, as it may scare the giant. In case of an emergency, the fire exits are on the left, right and main entrance to the theatre. Warning, this performance contains flashing and strobe lights, a scary giant and bad jokes. Thank you and enjoy the show.
Boys and girls,
hello.
Welcome to our tale of Jack from the Dairy. And my name's Adina, the Eco Fairy. I tend the soil and watch out for what grows.
You lay on the mat and then hold your nose. Slime Ball's the name. I'm known all over town.
I wish you'd keep your emissions down.
Oh, winch, winch, winch. Let's hear your hisses and boos. That's right, I know who you choose. I serve the wicked giant Blunderball, of whom you'll all be seeing rather more. She's just a mucky farmer's fairy friend.
And I'll see you off to a sticky end. And now, boys and girls, after three, you're going to give me your very best cheers. Are you ready?
Yeah.
One, two, three.
Yeah. Oh, Belta.
Thank you all so much, buddies.
One little cheer and you start to grow.
And quite while you're here, I really don't know. Down on this earth, my magic is stronger.
Ah, but this time around, my wand is longer.
Slime ball again, you fall into the sea. Look, once again, you got a magic.
I suppose you think that's rather funny.
To see your face, I'd have paid good money.
I'm very glad, because you'll see it again. I'll get my own back to the power of 10. You and your old-fashioned quaint country ways. I'll break you all in a matter of days. Ha ha ha!
Oh dear, he does seem rather cross. But he'll just have to learn he's not the boss. But for now, boys and girls, let's meet Tuffy Bad Jack. But don't worry, my dears, I'll sort out the flag. See you later, boys and girls!
Something peculiar, something for everyone.
a working lad in the dairy business. A simple, insignificant nobody.
Aww.
Aww. But hey, that's enough about me because today on this beautiful morning we are blessed by the presence of royalty. Exalted, taken to a whole new level of glory by her
stop
picture.
Stop singing for your loveliness.
Princess Demelza.
Shut up, Jack.
Dancing with the common folk.
I'm leaving.
Oh, but we love you dancing with us.
No, you're just saying that.
We really do.
Well, stop all this royal business.
All right, it's stopped, it's finished.
Promise?
Promise. Not another word.
Good.
Make way, please, Royal Highness.
I'd say that.
Oh, it's royal wonderfulness, King Bertram the Prince.
What's it been wrong with us?
I don't know.
Good people of Merrydale, what are you doing here?
Dancing.
Dancing?
Silence!
I was fucking hit my foot. Yes, you did.
Sorry.
Put yours out, go on the other side.
Not putting me on pit.
Good idea.
Daddy?
Yeah. Do not call me Daddy!
Oh, silence!
Ow!
Majesty!
You hit my foot again! Yes, you did!
No.
Give me that thing! You're not to be trusted! Demelza, do not call me Daddy! Not in front of the common people!
The common people!
Silence!
Silence!
Yes, thank you, Flunkheads. Right now, where was I? Oh, yes. Good people of Merrydale, I am here today.
We can see that.
Will you shut up? I see what you made
me
do.
Me?
Yes, you bring this silly thing out of you. See what you like.
Oh, that's not fair, Daddy.
Do not call me Daddy. I am the king. Sorry, Funkhead, but don't bring this silly thing out of you again. Now look here, everybody. I am here today to bring you some good news. And some bad news. The good news is we finally paid the giant's tax. The bad news is that in unprecedented gesture of my will, giant has decided to double the tax.
What?
Double the tax.
Double it?
Yes, I will be sending his wicked henchman, Slimebob, to oversee the payment.
You said it, Daddy-o.
Do not call him Daddy-o.
No, that's quite all right, Mr. Slimebob.
That's right. But don't you worry, Grandma. The giant's a reasonable man. He'll give you time.
Really?
Yeah, you got about half an hour.
Half an hour?
30 minutes. And the clock's ticking.
But we can't possibly wait.
And if the money isn't raised on time?
Yes?
The giants are going to marry the princess.
Marry the princess!
I'll turn all the year's 6 children in the land to stone.
Year 6? But they'll miss their steps.
I wouldn't worry about the kiddies marrying you. I'd think he'd go for the princess.
But he can't just marry the princess.
Says him. You see the size of him?
I don't care how big he is.
Ah, got a soft spot for yourself, have you?
Don't answer him, Jack.
Jack, is it? I'll remember that. And in the meantime, see if you can come up with the money. Don't try any funny business. Not unless you all want to get eaten. All that V5-fold fun stuff gives me the creeps. Anyway, let's have a nice big boo and I'll be on my way. See you all in 29 minutes! Silence!
A new tax to be paid immediately. Flunkhead, see to it straight away.
But we can't fight for it, it's not possible!
But we must.
Hang on, we could fight him.
Fight
him?
Should say fight the giant. I'd do it with my own songs.
Or maybe you'd prefer to have him as a son-in-law.
But it's not safe. He'll eat us.
We have never tried.
I don't want to try, but he's eaten.
Well, I think Jack's right.
Jack? Jack? What's he doing on first team now as a common zebra? Who is this Jack?
That's Dame Trot's boy, Your Majesty.
Dame Trot? Zero. But she hasn't even paid her rent.
Because you never pay for the milk? Ooh.
That is true, Your Majesty.
Silence, Flunkhead. Melza, You're not to chat, dance, or jig about the commoners.
But that's not
but
fair.
Especially not to common commoners, whose ones aren't even up to date with the rent.
But
that's my last words. Everyone will have to go home to raise the money to pay the giant's tax. Come on, Flunkett, and you to the mezzo. You come with us.
Do any of you want to fight the giant?
No! Yeah.
How would that be the trap in this huge pit? You look like you want to fight. I always know you.
Where are you?
Oh, it's Mum. I've got no time for little Daisy right now. I've got bigger things to worry about. I'll have to save Princess Demelza myself.
Oh, here we are. Hello, everybody.
Hello.
That's right, can you wait?
Hello.
Ooh. Here I am, all ready for the morning milk route. And I've got no milk. I can't find my cow Daisy. I thought my boy Jack was going to help me, but never mind, I've bumped into all of you. How are you all? You all having a good time?
Yeah!
You're going to have to do better than that. Are you all having a good time?
Yeah!
Yes, Dad.
A bit better. Once more for luck. Are you all having a good time?
Yeah!
Great, there's no need to shout. Now, let me introduce yourself. I'm Dave Trott. Madonna Trot, but you can call me Match. Fit as a fiddle and wonderfully preserved for one of my age. You wouldn't think that I'm over 30, would you?
Yeah!
I am! That's right, widowed before my time! Oh, come on! Although it's a little bit before my time than that, loves. Anyway, you never know when you're going to meet the man of your dreams, do you? In fact, it might be here right now. Can we have the house lights up, please? Oh, what a lovely bunch of people. Oh, I'm only kidding. Take what talk about you, sir. Madam, I'm sorry. Hi, is there any men? No, I can't see it. Just what? Oh, yes. Oh, thank you, dear. Oh, you're gorgeous, you are. What's your name? Mr. Gibson, are you a teacher? Are you strict? Oh, very strict. What, my Christian Grey, I'm sure I am. I'll see you later. Right, all this chatting, we're going to get the milking done. Oh, I don't know where my cow Daisy is. Oh, she's got a mind of her own, she has. Fortunately, our cowman, Simple Simon, doesn't seem to have a mind at all. In fact, I think he's lost her. I mean, how do you lose a cow? And here's me, run off by your feet. Never mind, they'll be back in a minute.
I've been trying to catch Daisy.
Oh, never mind that. Now you're here, you can say hello to all the boys and girls.
Oh gosh. Hey, Paul. There's loads of them.
What?
Shy.
Oh, never mind that. Just stand by me and introduce yourself. Louder than that. Louder.
Hello, I'm Simon.
And friendlier.
Friendlier.
Louder and friendlier.
Louder.
Hello, I'm Simon.
Can you put a little bit of humour into it?
Humour?
Yes, just louder, friendlier, with a little bit of humour. Why don't we get this lot to help you?
How do you mean?
Well, when you're feeling a little bit nervous, just shout out, help me, help me. And then this lot will shout out.
Don't worry, Simon, it's probably not as bad as you think, so try and be a bit brave.
That might be a little bit long, Dizzy. How about be brave, Simon?
That's brilliant.
It is, isn't it? Will you help us?
Yeah!
Okay. I'm going to try and scare Simon, and then he'll shout out.
Help me, help me!
Then you lot shout out, be brave, Simon. Go ahead.
Yeah.
Good. Right. Run! No, no, no. You're supposed to shout, help me, help me, help me. Come on, get out, we'll try it again.
Sorry.
Right. Run!
Help me, help me!
Be brave. About. Why don't you say hello to the boys and girls? Give them a curtsy.
Emma.
I think she went a bit too far.
Are you stuck here? Come on, Simon, let's help her out.
Come on! Come on! Come on!
Oh, fantastic.
I want the princess! No!
Nice to see you all again so soon! Now, that'll be one princess if you please.
Well, we can't find her.
No fibs now! No, you're not losing a daughter, you're gaining a son.
Never!
Red!
I took my time, but then I'm organic.
No!
Now just shut up! Keep still and don't fidget. Or one way for this one and your pops is a midget.
But!
Off you go now. No princess, no tax. Or I'll use my magic to the max.
You already brought my wife. There's no need to get shirty. Just remember, we like to play dirty. Ha ha ha!
Idea.
Let's all celebrate in a special way.
Let's make today a public holiday!
Yeah!
I'm up for a dance.
And a bit of a jig.
You up for a
dance? Go on, who gives a fig?
Woohoo!
That's it, you all happy?
No!
No!
That's good, because neither am I. I'm not happy. Not happy at all. And when I'm not happy, bad things happen. Very bad things. For starters, I'm going to ruin that Jack. Just to spite a Dina. And then I'm going to find a way to steal away the princess. That should keep the giant happy, because he's a romantic at heart. Oh. And it'll spite Adina even more, which is right up my street. Don't you agree with me?
No!
You don't agree with me?
No!
Well, we'll just see you as the last laugh. I thank you.
Come on, Plumpkin. Yes. Hurry up. Hurry up.
I'm going as quickly as I can, Your Majesty.
I'm glad to hear it. You appear to be rooted to spot. Oh, rooted to spot. That's a good one, isn't it, Plumpkin?
Yes, Your Majesty. Can I ask a question, Your Majesty?
By all way.
Why am I dressed as a tree?
Oh, good question, Plumpkin. Good question. Take a leaf out of my book and never be afraid to ask a question.
No, Your Majesty.
Oh, leaf out of my book. That's never good, isn't it? Good one, isn't it, Blanket?
Yes, Your Majesty.
You're dressed as a tree to remain entirely inconspicuous.
Really?
I wish you to blend in with your surroundings and keep a close watch on the princess. She always seems to take the walk inside the afternoon. I want to know exactly what's happening and exactly what she means, especially that uppity Jack Trot. I want to put a stop to all his sad and dazzling comments. I want to cut it out root and branch. Don't try to comedian with me.
No, Your Majesty, but pardon, Your Majesty.
Your job is to find out what's happening and report back to me. Now, quiet, she's coming. You're almost invisible, Mrs. Scott. Stick to her like glue.
What, Your Majesty?
Like glue, Plumpkin. Like glue.
Daddy? Daddy? That's funny. I thought Daddy was here. I'm sure I heard his voice. Demelza! Jack! What are you doing here?
I followed you.
Why? Because I wanted to talk to you. I hurt my father didn't see you. Of course not, I was very careful.
He's been even more protective of me than he used to be.
And it's really annoying.
Really?
Does it worry you?
Of course it does.
Why is that then?
No?
I think I'd like to hear you say it.
Well,
yes.
I just like talking to you, that's all.
I mean, I really, really like talking to you and getting to know you and finding out what you want.
Well, do you know what, Jack Trot?
What?
I'd like getting to know you soon.
Take my hand, take a breath, pull me close, and take one step. Keep your eyes locked to mine, and let the music be your guide. Now would you promise me that you'll never forget?
Catching lightning, the chances of finding someone.
completely.
We've all gone dancing.
When you joined in, prancing around like a demented bulbing bush, you incompetent loon. Now you better well find her again and keep an eye on her this time. I'll have her chopped down, locked, and pumped into paper.
To see his milk daisy.
I've never seen a cow been milked before.
Oh, well, we're in for a treat, and we better get started because his daisy's milking time and routine is vitally important for your average cow.
Moo!
Oh, I mean you're above average top of the range, cow. Now, let's begin. Put the stool here and the pail like so, and then. Oh, Daisy! Come on, get up! Now you realise it is the milker's job to sit on the stool, whereas the cow
sits on the milker.
That's a bit of a mistake.
Of course it's a bit of a mistake. Get up, Daisy. Cow does not sit on the milk.
The milker sits on the cow.
Watch it, sunshine. The milker sits on the little stool that has been carefully placed by the cow. She seems a bit skittish today.
I've got a joke. Maybe that'll put her in the mood.
Go on then.
One sec. Why does a milking stool only have three legs?
We don't know. Why does a milking stool
only have three legs?
Did it! Look, right, did or didn't? She was here.
No, she wasn't.
Oh, yes, she was.
She wasn't.
I give up. I'm here for the rent. Where is it?
Oh, well, is it over there?
Don't move it.
There.
1 year's rent, £50. Where is it?
He's got it. I give it to him earlier on.
Yeah. 1 year's pound. 1 year's rent. Where is it?
Oh, there it is.
But that's my £50.
See?
Yes, it is. Now you owe me £100.
Right. So let me get this straight. I owe you £50 rent. £50 that I mistakenly took from your top pocket.
Yes, I am. That's £100.
Well, I'd better pay you back then, hadn't I?
Yes, you better have it. When are you going to pay?
Good question.
I'm glad you like it. Have you got a good answer?
On the 33rd.
But that means never. Exactly. I've had my fill of this. I've had enough. I've had more than enough.
Just leave it on the side of your plate, then left.
You do can't wait. I'll be out of the street, thrown out on your ear. If I find your son injuring my daughter,
yes,
I'll chuck you out all over again.
Uh-oh. Oh, Simon. What are we going to do? Out on the street with no home to go to.
See that I am me, and so also is called Daisy.
I'll change my voice to one that's local. So he'll think that I'm a yokel.
Come on, Daisy, you're very tired. It's not much further.
Hello, young sir.
A local yokel.
My first time, young sir. And I can't help seeing that you have with you a cow. Nervy, ain't she?
Oh, she's just a bit shy, that's all.
Oh, what a coincidence. I've been looking for a shy cow all day.
Really?
Really? Especially one that's so pretty and so beautiful. Oh, clumsy old... I mean, nice cow. Is she for sale?
Well, we were just going to the market to get the very best...
Look, no further. How would a nice big bag of gold suit you? Enough to please your mum.
How did you know? Boys and girls, think I should sell her?
Yeah!
Sure! Does it ever have much gold in here?
Yeah!
Just cut the chat and consider the gold. You get the wonga and the cow gets...
Oh.
It's a bargain then. Of course she will. Bye bye. Bye-zy, bye-zy.
How's that for a result? One in the eye for Adina. And a nice bit of steak for Blunderbore. Now. I think someone's coming. It looks like the princess, and she's being chased by a tree. Okay, I'm going to tie up Daisy over here and wait to see what's what.
Look, it, will you stop following me? I know perfectly well it's you, and I don't care what you brought back to my father. I want to see if I can find Jack. Why do I want to find Jack? Because I love him. There, tell that to my father with knobs on.
With knobs on, Mr. Mouser.
What are you doing here?
Oh, well, just overhearing your little secret and knowing how the giant pines for you. I'm just here to kidnap
you. Let me go, you son of a bitch! I'm like, go and do something, fuck it!
Me?
Yes, you are command.
Oh yes, would you let the princess go, please?
I'm shaking in my boots. Go spend the night with the wildwood trees.
Look, he come back! Look, he come back!
Now, princess, you really must forgive me. For up to the giant we must go. With you like so, and the cow in tow. Ha 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 ha!
Yes!
doing?
Mum, I got the best news.
You have?
Yeah. You still there, and I'll come to you.
Oh, it looks like things might be looking up.
Do you have some, Mrs. Mum,
Mum.
Well, how did it go? Did it go well?
You'll never guess.
Try me.
Well, sit down.
I've just got up.
I just don't want to give you too much of a shock.
Oh, I want to be shocked. Shock me, Jen, shock me.
All right, then. Grab a hold of this.
I'm shocked, Jen. What's in there?
Gold.
Gold? Oh, I've never seen so much money in all my life.
Oh,
strange people and things like that, eh?
Look how high it goes! Right into the clouds!
You should close it!
Just as I thought, I've caught you red-handed. The princess is here. It's quite obvious to me. Go on, take her.
That's ridiculous.
Don't contradict me. I'm the king.
In that case, I will.
Hairy? How do you mean hairy?
I mean confusing and all contrary.
All contrary, but first you said hairy. This isn't all confusing, this is all airy fairy.
Let's not argue on the side of dairy.
I once knew a girl whose name was Mary.
Oh, shut up.
Let me speak plain and tell you true.
That's all I'm asking you to do.
Where's Imelda? Is she okay? It is true, she has been taken away.
Oh no.
Oh yes.
Oh dear.
Transported to the giant idea.
But eco-cones make things grow.
And your point is?
Oh, you're all so slow.
Hey, I could climb there.
What's that big dog thing?
Come on, Mum, it's almost as if it's been put there on purpose.
He's right. Up you go. We'll say no more about the rain.
But he's my only son.
Mum, I have no choice. I have to rescue Demelza.
Well, that giant's such a nasty man.
And I shall help her all I can. The special sword has magic power to call upon in the yellow. Oh, no,
not
it
down.
Wait for a second. She must be casting a spell.
No worries.
I got it.
Thank you.
Oh, Jack. Must you go now?
I must.
He must.
All right then, Joe.
Then off I go. Without delay.
Bye, Jack.
Trying to win a battle bear to claim a wife of a maiden bear.
Here we coming up, he's already coming.
just in time to see how we prepare our dish of the day. A delicious Jack Trot kebab.
Yeah!
Oh, dear.
Yes!
You horrible turd!
I'll take that as a compliment. Here we come. Get in.
Jack, watch out! I'll just have to keep going forward and do what I can.
How are you clumsy, Anne? How are you pushing off books?
I'm so sorry, Your Majesty.
All right, there's no need to fuss. Where are the others?
I'm here!
Where's the others?
I'm all in. I never want to see another bee for the rest of my life.
So here we are, all present in the crowd.
Yes, Your Majesty.
What do we do now?
Well, if we want to help Jack, we've got to find him first.
In the giant's castle?
Yes.
Where he actually lives?
Yes.
With this giant creature?
Yes.
In Slimeball?
Yes.
And recipes for eating people?
Yes, yes, yes.
I've got an idea.
Oh. What? What?
Let's go back down the beanstalk.
Good idea. Oh, no, no, stop. You can't do that.
Why am I not?
Why? Because it's the coward's way out. We're no cowards, are we? No. We're men. I mean, you're men, and I'll go back down the beach.
Hang on. Either we all go or we all stay.
All right. I wish I was somewhere else.
Sure do I.
Bye.
Make you swear and curse.
Wait,
when you're chewing on life's gristle, don't crumble, give a whistle, and this'll help things turn out for the best. And always look on the bright side.
Go down the beanstalk.
What are we going to do? Get into
into the castle without anybody up here noticing. We've got to find Jem, find the Melzer, rescue her from under the nose of the giant and all these little icky creatures, and then all back down the beanstalk and a happily ever after for his own.
How do we do that?
Oh, simple.
Where's Petty?
Oh!
She's just over here.
Oh!
Little treasure.
Oh. Are you going to lay me a leg then, Hetty?
One a day, regular as clockwork.
Give it to the Melzer as a little prezzy from me.
Move. There you go, he's such a gentleman.
Shut your face, you grumbling little toad. Where's that intruder you told me about? Have you caught him yet?
Not quite.
Not quite? Well, get after him, you dim-witted slug!
Yes, a thousand apologies. I'll get after him right away.
This is the life, pal. Me in my kitchen. You in your little cage.
I'm not speaking to you.
You just did. I've got the key right here, baby. Busy day, huh? I might just have a little nap.
Who's there?
It's me.
Jack!
Shh.
I mean, Jack, thank goodness you're here. He came after me.
Of course I did. How can I get you out of here?
The key's on his belt. And Jack, they've got Daisy.
Daisy?
Shh.
It's all right, Stacey. I think I can get it off. Now, where is Daisy?
In the larder.
Okay. First we'll free you, then we'll get Daisy. Here, it's just about coming.
3, 5, 4, 4
What's that?
I don't know. Another giant?
I smell the blood of...
What is it?
An Englishman!
What happened?
Simon?
Jack! What are you doing here?
I'm pretending
to be the giant. Why? To get into the castle.
The real giant is already here!
The real giant?
He's right here and he's really, really big! Help me, help me!
Be here, Simon!
What's going on? What's going on? I'll smash you all to pieces!
Wait!
What?
They're here to...
Bend the drains!
No, they're here to sing to you.
Sing to me?
Yeah, that's right. Slimeball and I, we made some music as a special treat.
You did that for me.
Of course we did. You like music. Elvis makes you sleepy. And when you wake up, you can eat them.
Sounds good. Relaxing and nutritious.
Eh?
What sort of music do you like best?
Well, I like a bit of everything, really. You know, classical, opera, rock, all the stuff from the 70s, of course. And, MC Hammer.
You like him?
Oh, yes. He's one of my favourites.
I'm going. I'm gone.
I'm really sorry, Slimeball.
Quick, Jack, run!
Come back here, you made me kill Slimeball. Creatures, creatures, catch the bees. Catch the bees.
It's Daisy the cow! It's Dame Trot! It's still Dame Trot! And it's Daisy!
on the tide. King Bertram, Jack Trot, Princess Martha, Dame Trot, and Simple Simon. But, oh my goodness, what's happening now?
Jack Trot's not only swung his hat in the way the beanstalk, and the whole lot's coming down!
I'm a
falling down. Oh, I enjoyed that. And then I do like a good sing song. Do you like a good sing song?
Yes!
I said, do you like a good sing song?
Yes!
Fantastic, because there's nothing else to do, is there? It all turned out just as I cunningly planned up the beanstalk. All down safely, except for the giant, of course. But he'll be back next year somewhere else. And it's a happily ever after for us all.
Fun.
Our kingdom is now on his skin.
He married me, I'm worth a mint.
I can't believe I'm also wed.
And I'm just glad that I'm not dead.
But when he's staying, he has three.
So that just leaves it up to me.
And me.
And me.
And all our crew to say.